Listen, honey, I know you've been busy around the house all day, so you don't have to bother making me dinner tonight. I got a little surprise for you.
Oh.
I'm going to the ball game tonight.
Al?
Huh?
You're not going to the game tonight.
Sure I am. See, let me explain something to you. I work all day. And when somebody works all day, they need to have some fun at night. Now, I don't actually expect you to understand any of this, but trust me, I'm your husband. I know best.
Well, isn't staying home with me fun?
Don't wait up.
Al, you're not going to the game tonight.
Oh, I see. You misunderstood me. You must have thought I said, honey, is it okay with you if I go to the game? You know, like a question. There's no question about this.
No, there isn't. You cannot go to the game tonight.
Why not?
Because I invited company over.
Company? Who the hell would want to come over here?
But you know that honeymoon couple that moved next door?
No.
Well, I invited them over. I thought I told you.
You didn't. Look, I worked hard all day. The last thing I want to do is spend the whole evening with people I don't know.
Now, look, they are new in the neighborhood. They have lived here for 2 months, and they have no friends. We have lived here for 15 years, and we have no friends. Al, I want to have some friends.
Wait a second, wait a second. Are you implying that it's my fault you have no friends?
Oh, no. It's me who sits in front of the TV set burping with my hand thrust down my pants.
You keep it cold in this house, Peg.
Every night when the kids go out, it's just you and me. Can't you see how boring that is for me, honey? Look, all I am asking is that we have some people over for one night and for you to be nice.
Oh, I'm gonna be nice? How's this for nice? I'm not even gonna be here. I'm going to the game.
All right, Al, fine. But before you go, I would just like to say three things. The bank book is in both of our names. The credit cards are in both of our names, and the stores are still open.